The Tools menu in the main menu bar contains the following options. At the very top, we have the New Terrain command, and if we click on this, we get the New Terrain Wizard. This allows us to create a new patch of terrain by giving it a location and a certain number of patches. We can then click Next and be taken to the next step in the creation process. But for the time being, I'm going to cancel this. We actually have some terrain videos lined up for a little bit later. And moving down from here, we have Check Map for Errors. This allows you to check for errors without having to necessarily build anything. If we click, here we see a few errors popping up. We have some paths that need to be rebuilt, which of course is irrelevant as we have no paths. It's saying we need to rebuild our lighting, and it's warning us that we're using the default or null material on some of our surfaces. So let's go ahead and close that. Back under Tools, we have Clean BSP Materials. Now, Logan, would you like to explain to everybody what this command does?
Well, this is based on the Check for Errors window showing null materials as warnings. Now, the reason that we might need something like Clean BSP Materials is that when you have a series of brushes defining geometry, you often have sections where these brushes join. Mm-hmm. And in between the brushes, you technically have what are known as invisible faces.
Right.
Faces that the engine calculates and acknowledges, but don't actually render and are non-selectable inside of the editor.
Right, this would be most apparent in a subtractive style level where maybe you have a large room carved out and then you have another subtractive brush coming off of that to form maybe a corridor. Right there where those two brushes join, you technically have invisible faces that don't render and you can't really see.
Right, and where the problem comes from is when you have created these brushes using the null material, but then can't get back to these now invisible faces in order to correct the null material problem. What Clean BSP Materials will do is it will look for such faces and assign a special invisible material to them so that way the null reference is cleaned up. It will be referencing an actual material, and that will remove the warning from the Check for Map Errors window.
Right, it's a way to just clean up that error window. Now, moving down from here, we have Replace Skeletal Mesh Actors. This is more of a legacy command, not something you'll find yourself using very often. What this is here for is a way to replace an older style of skeletal mesh, which would sometimes crash versions of the editor, not something that I really foresee you ever really having to reach for. So we'll move on down to Add Pickup Light. And here's what this does. Let me actually demonstrate this one. I'm going to open up my generic browser by clicking on the Open Generic Browser Window button. I'll move over to the Actor Classes browser over in the tab, and then we'll scroll down a bit, and I'm going to expand Navigation Point. We will expand Pickup Factory, UT Pickup Factory, and UT Weapon Locker, and I'm going to select UT Weapon Locker Content. Let's go ahead and close the Actor Class browser. I'll right-click on the floor and choose Add UT Weapon Locker Content here. And what this does is this adds a weapon locker for us to, you know, put a flat cannon on so we can run up and go pick up a flat cannon, a very important actor that you'll be putting in probably a lot of your levels. However, if we now come under Tools and check the map for errors, a few new errors have popped up, one of which, though, is UT Weapon Locker Content 1 doesn't have a pickup light near it. So let's go ahead and close that. Under the Tools menu, we can choose Add Pickup Lights, which will automatically find any such actors that require a pickup light, and it'll create one for us. So let's go back under Tools, go back under Check Map for Errors, and we can see that we no longer have that error in place. So that is a quick look at the options available inside the Tools menu.